Nice. So, where are you working right now? Hi, Santosh. All right. So, which software are you dealing in, Rajiv? Good. Are you into developing e-commerce sites as well? Thanks. We are going to talk a bit about e-commerce today. You can be a great help to the other participants as well. Hi, Vinay. Yeah, hi Vinay. This is Nikhil this side. This is not the same Nick you probably will be knowing. Rajiv, Santosh and Vinay, we are going to wait for a few more minutes for other participants to come and then we are going to start the session. Meanwhile, Vinay, can you just let me know what you do? What are your plans in future? We want to make this an interactive session, so I want to know about it. And Santosh, you as well. Nice, Santosh. Very good. Where are you working right now? Nice. So in marketing communication for Taurus Power Tonics, Santosh, what all do you do in, I mean, you're taking care of which all parts of the communication? Hi Siddhartha, can you hear me? We'll wait for 2-3 more minutes and then we'll start it. Catalog, event management, website management, magazine, and management, very nice. Hi Sunil. We'll wait one more minute, my friends, and then we'll start the session. Sunil, Siddhartha, can you just let me know what do you guys do? Hi, Arushi. Why don't everybody just in a single line let me know what they do so that I can understand what you basically are into and what you want in life. So we'll shape the session accordingly. Yeah, good evening to everyone. Yes, Arushi, Nick is not well. And Nikhil is there right now. I'm Nikhil. I'll be taking a guest lecture for you today. What suggestion you want, Santosh? Let me know. I mean, in what field you want these efficiency? All right. This course you are doing, Santosh, will help you out, I guess, to a great extent. This session particularly is for the reason that we give you an industrial perspective. We are not going to talk about, I'm not only speaking to Santosh right now, I'm speaking to everyone. This session is not going to be very textbook session, very technical session. No, it's not going to be that. It's going to give you an industrial perspective. I am a co-founder of an e-commerce website called Romania.com. It's into fashion, merchandise, and it's a marketplace site. We have various sellers on board with us, and we are dealing in multiple products. So I'll try to bring in the Santosh has just asked a question in between, so I'm putting it on hold, my decision. But I can't start as a fresher with a experience. It doesn't matter, Santosh. I'll come to your answer. First, I'll introduce myself completely so that you understand. So this session is basically gonna give you a industrial perspective of how companies look for digital marketers. What is their expectation? What is your expectation? Where the marriage can be done, what is e-commerce, how it can be done, on the operations and running part of it and marketing part of it, not the technical part of it. Technical, in you guys are semi-technical anyways, or you are anyway software developers. So we're not going to talk about anything about technical today. We're only going to talk about the marketing perspective, the operations perspective, and the outline. And we'll pick few cases in between. We'll pick Romania.com as one of the case, and it'll be dominant in the session. We'll also gonna pick one or two cases in between. And the latter half of the session, this is gonna be the first half of the session, and the latter half of the session will be towards the Facebook promotions. How to create an ad? What do you look to create an ad? We'll go with the session. I'm not sure how many of you have run a practical campaign on Facebook. Can just let me know if they have run a practical campaign on practical. I mean, they have actually run a campaign on Facebook. Has anyone of you have run a campaign on Facebook? All right. So this will be Vinay has done. So Vinay, you may find it little easy when we go through. But I hope that you may find a one or two thing new in this, but for everybody else it will be a new experience today. I'll give you a demonstration today, and I'll request everyone to at home do a little practice of it for a few days, and once you are done with Facebook promotions, believe you me, working on Google platform won't be difficult there. They are more or less the same structure which they follow, right? So this is how our session is gonna be. I'll also give you one example of how an email marketing, which is a part of digital marketing, can be used for exploitation by one brand. I'll give you a practical example today. So you'll understand that the tool which you're learning can make a brand or make or break a brand. It has such a big power. So this is how we're going to be. All right, so I'm going to start the session now. Somebody has switched on its microphone. I request you to please mute that. I'll ask you if in case I want to hear something from you, I'll ask you and then only switch on it.
But
hello, Siddhartha? Yes, I'm mute. All right, so we're going to start this session now. Making it full screen. Now every one of you know about me. Even I know a bit about you guys. Not everyone, but yes, I know a little few about you. Today we are going to discuss on 5 or 6 major aspects. We are going to discuss on outline of what is digital marketing. Then we are going to gradually move towards what is the expectation of industry from a digital marketer and what is your expectation from the industry, and then we are going to talk. We are going to make it full interactive session, so you can just write whatever in between. If you want to hold me in between for a certain period of time, you can just pop up. So we'll do accordingly. We'll pick a few cases. One goofa which I said, or a misuse of a email marketing tool by one company and giving advantage to the other, will come to that also. We're going to also talk about Facebook today in depth, and of course we're going to talk about e-commerce as such in detail. So digital marketing is a byproduct of marketing, and if it's a byproduct of marketing, it actually carries every principle which marketing does. Like for example, marketing doesn't start with promotion. So when you're taking this course, or when you want to be a digital marketer for any company, if you think that learning of how to use a tool is more than enough, then no. It is a job more or less limited to the clerical work. You can learn it in few days, in few sessions. But it is not completely it is not a complete framework actually. The digital marketing doesn't start with the product is ready and you just need to promote it. And in promotion also you have a clear objective of, you know, finding such and such hits or finding such and such page likes or something like that, or whichever tool you're using. No, it is not like that. You have to devise. You also have to objectivize what you want. And why do you want it? So if you think about that and you go about that and you get an entry as a digital marketer and you're not discussing with the team or the CMO or the CEO about that, then the outlook which should come out is not that you only know to make a studio things. What do I mean by studio things? Studio means basically you're working as an executor. No, you're not working as an executor, working as a planner. So this is the industrial expectation mainly. So digital marketing product is basically starts with the product and not the promotion part of it. Promotion comes later into the stage. Even in devising a product and devising a business plan, or setting up an year or quarter, half yearly or yearly or 5 years objective, your contribution is going to be how and what changes in product can be done so that the promotion can be relatively easier. How devising a product, especially if it's an online product, how it is going to synergize with the operations part of it. So it is not that it will not be your responsibility. Probably you will not be the key person responsible for that. There will be product managers responsible for that. But your contribution is must over there. In fact, they will devise the product outlines based on your inputs. because to achieve a target, an yearly target of revenue target, the part of a marketing budget also plays an important role. What significant percentage you suggest, or what significant percentage team suggests and you implement, these things matter. Like for example, I'll give you an example. Suppose you're making an yearly plan with a team, and you mark that in the coming year, in 2016, we are gonna score 100 GMV. GMV is gross merchandise value. I'm also, while giving the examples and case study, I'm also gonna use certain words of the industry so that you understand it, right? And I'll also explain it. So if any one of you wanna make notes of it, you can make notes of it also simultaneously. Voice is breaking. Wait, Santosh, I'll just check it out. Is it coming proper now, Santosh? We're just pausing for a minute. In the meanwhile, Santosh, and everybody else, is voice is now coming proper? Once you say yes, we'll proceed. This is showing everything fine over here. I don't know why it is. Now it is it coming proper? All right, so we're gonna resume now. When suppose a team has made an GMV. GMV is gross merchandise value. In an online space and an e-commerce space, there are two terminologies used. If a site, a website, a store, an online store, if it is selling its own made products, then they use the word revenue, because whatever they're gonna sell, they're gonna get the money out of it, and the total sum of money they're gonna get out of selling their products, it is called revenue in the field of commercial activities. But there is a new concept introduced recently, which is marketplace. Not recently, it was introduced in India way back when eBay came, but it was not as per the accounting standards of American accounting standards. So it was pretty recent, pretty 20 years back. So GMV is when you have made an online platform, like Flipkart has done, like Amazon has done, like eBay is doing. And there are many, even womania.com is also a marketplace site. So what we do is we basically create a platform where we invite buyers and we invite sellers also. So sellers can put up their inventory and it will be sold on behalf of seller. So when seller sells it, if the product are sold total value of rupees 100, it is not our revenue. Our revenue is basically the commission percentage we are going to earn out of it. So it is called GMV. What is GMV? GMV is gross merchandise value. So rupees 100 worth of stock has been sold of various sellers on the platform for a certain period of time. So if your target is 100 GMV, there will be two questions asked at the initial stage of planning from the DM, digital marketer. What will be these two? First, how much money do you need so that we can achieve 100 GMV? What will be your target? How you're gonna achieve that? Why we are gonna spend whatever your money you are asking, only on online spends and not on offline spends? Why on digital marketing, not on others? And what is the scheduling? I mean, you may ask that to achieve 100 rupees, I need 30 rupees. And though it sounds higher, the management can approve it, but they will ask you that, are you gonna spend 30 rupees straight away? Or you're going to spend periodically? If periodically, how, in which channels you're going to use that? Why do you think that it will work? And how do you make sure that 100 GMV happens in how many users you want to bring in first? What is your strategy and all that? So as a DM, you should have answers of all this, and not only that, okay, I'll use Facebook and I know how to use Facebook, or I'll use Google AdWords and I know how to use Google AdWords. or I'll do SEO and I know how to do SEO, or I'll do email marketing and know how to do email marketing. This is, at the end of the day, will be left as a junior level work. So if you want to, you know, go from execution to marketing, or you know, in few years down the line, you want to be chief digital marketing officer of a company, then you have to have these answers. And if you really work hard, even now in an early funded company, you can be working as a chief DMO. It is not a distant dream, let me tell you. All right. So it basically starts with product and not the only promotion part of it. Let's also discuss a bit about what are the boundaries of digital marketing. Digital marketing, if you look, because internet or digital space is the newest entrant. Basically print came earlier, then TV came. Outdoor was anyways existent right from the start of the commercial activities way beyond, you know, 2000 years back. So the latest entrant is internet or digital. And even in digital, there are multiple layers now. We have desktop promotions, we have mobile promotions. You never know 3 years down the line what kind of promotion we have next. So how it happens is, for a company, when it places a budget, like this, they're gonna keep around, I'm talking about the established companies, especially if they're not in the online space. Like for example, companies selling cars, like for example, Maruti. They have recently launched Baleno. So for Baleno, their ideal way of planning or media planning will be that they're gonna spend around 35 to 40% on TV. They're gonna spend around 30-40% on print. They're gonna spend 10% on BTL activation, outdoor advertisement, and things like that. And then remaining 10% on digital. Now that was the ideal thing. But with the new penetration of internet nowadays, this 10% bracket, which earlier started from 2007-8 as 3-4%, has now reached 10%. For some companies, it is reaching 30-35%, and there are some companies that are only relying on that. So they are spending almost all the budgets on that, especially startups, especially products which are online based, because that is your den, that is your area. So it makes sense for them to do that. So when you make a plan, or when you make a product, and when you work on the promotions part of it, what is the boundaries of digital marketing? This slide, if you look into this slide, don't look onto the Romania part of it, look onto the Facebook icon part of it, and you'll understand what I want to say. Facebook has created a simple platform, very innovatively used, where the core product is absolutely free. They know that this kind of product will have a great traction, will have a great demand, and they have invested hugely in creating the free product. Once it is ready, they stretch the boundaries, and that stretchable boundary reaches to supplier and not the consumer parts. And then now asking all the suppliers or the, you know, supply side companies to use it in their advantage. So if I as a womania.com wanna promote womania.com, thinks this is the best medium to use it and put an ad, and what they're charging may be relatively inexpensive to the other offline media like print TV, but at the end of the day, it is not a cheap media. Google, Facebook has become really, really expensive now, because there are so many companies who are fighting for the same space, and they may charge a unit sum which is relatively lower, like for example 1 rupee to 1.5 rupee to 8-10 rupee per keyword or per click, but at the end of the day, they have a huge target sitting over there in their bag. So in nutshell, as our total budget, companies which start in online promotion start with somewhere around 6,000, 8,000, 10,000 rupees a day budget in only in one channel. Like for example, if you're gonna pick Facebook, they're gonna start with 8-10,000 rupees per day budget. So if they do a campaign of, let's say, 20-25 odd days, they eventually ended up paying a handsome amount. So all right. So it is like creating a tiger. When you go to a zoo, tiger comes straight to you. But there are different things. You have to pay for food. You have to pay for tickets. You have to, if somebody has made a cage of it, that vendor, the software developer in the field of making online products, their business have increased. So as a digital marketer, your requirement is not only limited to one area, which is creating a final B2C product. No, there is a huge demand of digital marketers, even in the companies of making software or software developing companies, in agencies who are using online promotions as their main product. So what they do is they basically like, for example, there are TV promotion agencies, print promotion agencies. There are agencies who only do online. So as a digital marketer, your requirement, you may be required on the platform of these companies as well. So you have to understand every perspective. This is my suggestion to you. Just for a second, I'm minimizing it. All right. Any question from anyone so far? And then we'll move towards what kind of websites, e-commerce websites we have. I'm just waiting for the response, yes or no. If anybody has a question so far, can just ask me. Please throw some light on yes and those on what. And let me do. So that I'll just go ahead, let Santosh complete his question. All right, Santosh, I'll tell you what is the industrial way of looking into it on planning. Though I have planned it to cover it in the later stage, but since you have asked me, I'll cover it right now. For an established company, for an established Indian company specifically, the norm which was used 3 years before was 6% of the total revenue is their marketing budget. This is the thumb rule on which various automobile companies, B2C companies, even HUL and PNG, all FMCG companies have established themselves. ITC also does that. This is the average, I'm saying. So there can be few companies like PNG, HUL and FMCG companies or apparel companies like Madura Garments. They have various sub brands under it. So certain brand may, if it's a new brand being launched, then the bracket of promotion with respect to estimated revenue will be relatively higher, can go up to 20-25% also. But ideally, for a company point of view, they basically try to keep it as 6%. We as Indian companies have not grown enough to consider marketing as an investment budget. We are still considering it as a cost budget. So So for cost, if you have 100 rupee revenue and your operations is basically around includes 40-50% of the cost, marketing is not left with more than 10% of the cost. So it was always a single digit number cost, but the things are changing now, especially with the introduction of application based products or aggregator based products like Ola. They have come with the concept that you need to have the user base first, and then only you can look for revenue. So they don't look for revenue in first phase. So there is no figure when it comes to percentage as a marketing budget. There it comes as an absolute budget. Like for example, if they think that they can have 100 users, they think, okay, 8 user ke liye we're gonna spend 7 rupees, or we're gonna spend 700 first. So this is how they look, and that this is the reason why Amazon.com is giving Amazon.in. They have given $2 billion 6 months back, and they have exhausted most of it, though many of us don't know about it in the papers, but they have done that. So while in planning a marketing budget, these are different perspective. First, you have to look on which stage your company is. Ideally, the company can be either of the three or four stages. It can be a startup company, it can be a little grown but making traction, or it can be a relatively grown, fully grown company, or it is now struggling to keep pace. So depending upon which stage, first the marketing budget has been has been allotted. Ideally, the percentage is kept at somewhere around 6-15%. Even these more than 6-10%, only aggressive companies are spending, not most of the companies. So, and then they divide those 6% into further breakup of 30-30, 20-20-10. This rule they follow. This is a very general kind of thing, but it is not an hard and fast. In Google Ads, budget starts for any amount. How about 4 bit? Yeah, same here. You can start with any amount. You can even start with 1 rupee. But it depends if you have it. All right. So let's quickly move towards digital marketing. Is now a product which is requirement of any kind of business. Now you cannot say it is a tool which you cannot live without for any brand. So if it's an all offline brand which is basically making the transactions or approaching people offline, for example automobiles, there the objective of digital marketing is awareness, spreading word of mouth, having a great connect emotionally, not on the later stage of the buying cycle. This is not their main objective. So what they do is they create the company website, the information oriented website, and they also use the upcoming trend in the market. Now there are various aggregators which have come in between, like for example carvalho.com, olh.com, quikr.com, and everything. So they have their own business model, but it is suiting the automobile manufacturers. So what they do is they use them as a tool. This is what they do. So for them, the content-based site is more important, but their e-commerce is not happening. But yes, they're using those companies as a medium to get onto the e-commerce traction. Then in e-commerce there are basically three main platforms which are being used as of now. There is four basically, and information is also in e-commerce nowadays. But anyways, it's own sale is basically when you have your own product, you're making it and you're selling it. Jabong was used to be an own sale till 2014 starting first quarter, but they have realized the potential of marketplace and they have started doing marketplace, but they're not fully or pure marketplace. I'll tell you what is marketplace. Marketplace is it's a platform where there are sellers and buyers, and they're pure marketplace like Snapdeal and Flipkart. Technically, on books is a pure marketplace, but it is not. Like for example, Snapdeal. Now, Snapdeal doesn't sell anything of its own. There is no subsidiary company also which is dealing in selling of the retail. So these are marketplaces. So we have sellers and buyers. eBay has started this concept. eBay is actually the main. eBay is like England of cricket. They have given cricket to the world. They have given e-commerce to the world. Most of our websites run on Magento platform. One of you is into software development. He may agree with me on that. It is one of the robust open source code platform available. But eBay is lagging behind, and these companies have overtaken. So it's England of cricket. But even in marketplaces, there are different classifications. There are pure marketplaces like Snapdeal, which doesn't sell anything of its own. And there are some who's using the technicalities, like for example, Flipkart. 70% of Flipkart's merchandise are sold from a seller called WS Retail, which is nothing but Flipkart. So it's a different company, but Flipkart has invested in that. So, like that. Amazon sells its own product as well as the seller's product, but it is mostly on the seller's base. But to maintain the quality and quantity, they use fulfillment method and all that. I won't get into it because it will get too heavy to for you to consume. But this is for you to understand that marketplaces have the power of scaling it up very fast compared to own scale, because if you are doing own sale, you have to purchase it, you have to invest in purchasing, and then you have to sell it. Their marketing promotion in own sale, you're always going to have very rigid on the budgets. Whereas in own sale, where in marketplaces, you'll have a hefty budget and you have to use many tools. What is the reason for that? A, they are only focusing on selling. So they are not focusing on procurement, and they have, therefore they have a bigger pocket. In addition to that, the marketplace can only survive because they work on a very less percentage. Amazon averagely works from 2% depending upon category. Like for consumer durables, they work on 2-3%, and they go maximum up to 14% of apparels and sunglasses. This is their maximum commission. So if a seller is selling ₹100 item, they're only going to get 12 rupees out of it. Out of that 12 rupees, they're going to manage everything. Their marketing budget, their company budget, their salaries, everything. And then also they have to make profit, and they also have to grow and outgrow the competition. So for marketplace, they cannot survive if they do not have maximum GMV or maximum revenue or maximum, you know, selling worth. So for them, marketing becomes not a marketing, pure marketing, it becomes a selling tool. So they just harp on you whenever you're going to come onto the online space, they'll try to catch you up. Like for example, if you search for any book or any item which is commonly available in online online shopping sites, you must have also observed that if you are revolving around Google sites, you'll see, or sites which Google AdSense and AdWords have a tie-up, you'll see that those products follow you, right? Like for example, if you search for a particular book, the ad of that particular book follows you even if you know, go on to other websites till the time you have not deleted the cookies from the browser. So they are so aggressive, they have to sell it somehow, because if they raise their bar on the economies of skill, then only they'll be able to survive and outrun the competition. Aggregators is a refined version of marketplaces. Aggregators have seen the potential of huge demand and supply, and they have come in between in a cosmetic, or you know, cascaded under the disguise of full-fledged company. Like for example, Ola Cabs are an interesting aspect. I'm sure many of you must have used Ola Cab as a service. So Ola Cab is an aggregator, but they send their invoice on the name of Ola Cab. This is an irony. If you are an aggregator, how can you say it? So technically they are aggregator because they are not using their platform of supply, but they're a full-fledged company itself. So if it's basically an outsourced sellers which they have on board, so seller of the service of cab service. So there also you will have heavy budgets. Like in marketplaces, aggregators are mainly trying to put up their domain not on the website business but on the app business and on the smartphone business. The foremost reason is they are only fulfilling one purpose, and if they have so many market smartphone users right now, it is best to sit in their phone rather than giving them option to go through the browser. All right, Santosh, I'll tell you how does invoicing work in e-commerce. If you are an own sell, John has arrived. Santosh, just for a minute, and everyone, just for a minute, I'm going to talk to John. John, this is the same session which we had yesterday. So it's your wish if you want to continue or log out. Anyways, now I'm resuming. And I'm answering the question of Santosh, who's asking, how does this invoice work in e-commerce? Invoicing work in e-commerce. See, if you are an old sell, then it is your invoice which happens. And you will start with one series, or whatever series you want to start. You can start with, let's say, 1001, and then you can go on invoicing it. Basically, in e-commerce, invoicing doesn't happen offline. Every seller prefers it to be online system. So I was talking about Magento. Magento has an inbuilt system that once an order is placed, it will automatically raise the invoice. So this is how the software are developing e-commerce. For a marketplace, the invoicing happens basis on order IDs. For any order in e-commerce, first of all, the primary key is order ID. Basically everything, like from logistics to invoicing to delivery to customers, everything revolves around that order number which you have. So first of all, an order ID is generated. Whatever product has been selected, the system knows at the background in the CMS, content management system, that this particular product belongs to this seller. So in your cart, if you have chosen, let's say, three products, out of which two products are of seller A and the third product is of seller B, the system knows that the two products which you have ordered is of seller A. So it will generate on basis reference to that order ID 1, then generate an invoice 1001 of the series of seller A and an invoice 1001 of the series of seller B. Both the invoices has comes onto the system on the CMS. A separate packing slip has been generated according to the order ID and taxation details of the seller A and B. Then this is the responsibility of the dispatch department to take its printout, the invoice printout and the packing slip. Invoice has to be put under either it is the company policy. They can send it through email, or if they want, they can also take out the hard copy and put it inside the packet, and a packing slip has to be placed over the packet. Even in packing slip, you have to have the TIN number and the taxation details. It may sound a little complex for everybody else, so if in case you're finding difficult, just let me know that you're not understanding this point, so that I can explain it further. I'm assuming that you know what is TIN number and what it is. Invoicing will be done from website server. It is on the books of the seller Arushi, but it is done from the website side, because website as a service give it to the seller, because they cannot ask seller every time. So every time an order comes, they will not ring seller again and again and say that raise the invoice. So what they do is they ask them that give us, they dedicate a series for them. Like for example, seller A 1001 is your series as a seller. So whatever order is going to come will raise according to the series. So first order will have A oblique 1001, the other order from the same seller will have A oblique 1002. But it is website's system responsibility or website responsibility or its staff responsibility to raise the invoice. A seller doesn't raise the invoice. Santosh and everybody else, I really won't mind asking as many as questions. I'll be really, really happy. I want to make it not a classroom session. I really want to make it an interactive session. So please ask me as many questions as you can. I'll make sure that whatever we have decided initially to cover, we'll cover the topics before 10:30. So don't be afraid even about that. All right, Santosh, I'm answering your question you have asked. Please don't mind that I'm gonna, but please let me know how supply chain and taxation work. How they avoid double taxation, I'll tell you. So now we're talking about supply chain. Supply chain is a little complicated. So if none of you is understanding, just stop me in between and try to give it a patient listening. For an e-commerce, and the best benchmark to study e-commerce is marketplace. So if anything which can work in marketplace will also work in own self. So for marketplace, the supply chain happens because there are sellers are distributed across India, and you're sitting, let's say your headquarters is there in Delhi and your seller is sitting in Gurgaon, it is sitting in Bikaner, it is sitting in Chirapunji. There will be different sellers sitting in different locations. So how do you manage the supply? Very good question, Nandosh, but I'll answer you how big companies do is, like for example, Snapdeal earlier doesn't use to check it. So what it is, everything is happening online. So suppose I'm a Snapdeal, my base is in Delhi, and let's say the seller is sitting in a Bikaner. So what they have to do is they have to list their products. The products have been listed to us, somebody have ordered from Bangalore. What happens is automatically the request has been generated on the ID of the seller. So seller knows that they have to pack it. They do not ask them to do the logistics. eBay does that initially, and that is why they lagged behind. And that is the potential which they have seen Snapdeal or Flipkart or any new company, including womania.com, that logistics is so complicated that we have to keep it, a supply chain is so complicated that we have to keep it to ourselves. So what Snapdeal does is they have outsourced it to e-commerce, only e-commerce supply courier companies. It can be a Blue Dart Wing, it can be DTDC, or it can be new companies like Delivery and all that, or GoJavas and all that. So what happens is there is an API integration. It's an Santosh, let me have the liberty of explaining it in the length I want to. It is not only you who have to understand it, everybody has to understand it, right? Since I answer that, John has asked what is marketplace. John, marketplace is when you're not selling your product, you're just a marketplace, like for example, Snapdeal. And there are different sellers on both. So there are different sellers and buyers, and they are using the platform as a brand name. All right, Santosh. Anyways, so what happens in with this is that there are different logistic companies, and all the three, the seller, the platform, and the logistic company, the courier company of e-commerce, all three has an API integration amongst themselves. So once an order is placed, everybody knows that an order is placed. And for order for today, a list comes in front of the logistic manager and it is passed on to the delivery boys. They'll go as a routine and they'll pick up the material from the seller. Seller has the responsibility of keeping it packed for a certain time. In Snapdeal, the rounds happen two times, 11 to 12 in the morning and 4 to 5 in the evening. So seller has to keep it ready with the packing norm which has been given by the seller. All right, API integration. John, though I'm not very technical, we have a CTO who handles, but API integration is basically you have a software, the other guy also have a software. For example, it's a logistic company and you are a online shopping site. So your part of thing, order details or whatever, you want it to be reflected directly to the communication happen automatically to the other vendor also, then there is an API integration. It's a technical word being used. We have an software developer in between, he can technically guide you, but basically there is a way of sending invoices or communication or information through email. So rather than we should not do that, there is an API integration. Like for example, I'll give you an example. If you draw some money from HDFC or from whatever bank you're using, you get a message straight away that such and such money has been. No, it is integration, not abbreviation. API is an abbreviation, I'll tell you what is API integration. API integration, that software, that SMS package has been integrated through API integration for your account in HDFC server. So what happens is, as soon as you do the transaction, it automatically responds to any action. So that is called the API integration. Anyways, I'll quickly come on to the logistic part. So this is how they do logistic. They'll pick it up and they'll deliver it, and it will be reflected onto the all the panel one. Since it is API integrated, the logistic company will first put it as under supply and then will put it as delivered. And once it is delivered, it will also show on the CMS, which is content management system of the seller as well as the platform, the online shopping site. So this is how the supply chain happens. Taxation, to avoid double taxation, this is what I'm saying. Any one of them takes the responsibility, and most of the times, or 100% of the times, it is the online shopping site's responsibility to raise the tax, raise the invoice. So since they raise the invoice and they pass on the software soft copy of the invoices to the sellers periodically, they only do the clerical part, the online shopping site, but the depositing of taxes is the responsibility of the seller. So what happens is, if I'm a seller and I'm on board or registered with, let's say, snapdeal.com, what I'll do is every week I'm going to get all the invoices which have been raised on my behalf. So I have all the invoices of this month end, and I'll go to the taxation department and do the taxation. So there is no double taxation that way. So I'm not raising it, I'm only doing the basically departmental part of it. And they are not doing any departmental part, they are only doing the raising of invoicing. So this is how the double taxation has been avoided. All right. I'm quickly moving to next. I hope we have no question in between. I'm just checking if we have any question. All right, so I'm moving on to the next. John, you were there yesterday, so you know about it. The primary response, this is to give you, I'll give you two examples, and you'll get the idea of what a CMO expects from a digital marketer, or what a CEO expects from a chief digital marketer. You can see that the co-founder of Quinto is an online app, it's a mobile app which basically fulfills the purpose of finding out a rated best dish you want to have. It's, for example, if you into a nearby area, for example, if you want to know that in my nearby area who gives the best biryani and what is the rating for that, so they do. You can just go to the Quinto app and you can search it down and you can look on to the information on that. So as a digital marketer, this is the expectation of the founder, of the man in charge, that if you have a Quinto product, Quinto app in your hand, and you want to promote it, how you're going to promote it to 100,000 users in 24 weeks? This is what I was saying initially, that they do not ask you that, do you know how to run Facebook ad, or do you know how to run Google ad, or do you know how to do SEO? No, they're not going to ask you that. They're going to ask you this, precisely this. And if you have a substantial answer of this, you are making, and this course is worthwhile for you. So let's keep it as a case study, just open. We are not going to check on what are the responses. We are just going to check what is the curiosity to give the answer. So just throw the answer for it. If this is the mobile app and you are the digital marketer, and I'm asking you that you have to raise 100,000 users, as in download, the app download have been done to the scale of 100,000 in 24 weeks, which is 6 months. How are you going to do that? Just throw anything. We'll do it. We'll do this for 5 minutes, and then we'll move directly towards creating a Facebook ad. Of course, advertisement, Rajiv. Advertisement is a part of marketing, but what in advertisement? SEO won't help it, John, to that extent, especially not in the earlier stage. Social media, yes. Arushi, which social media would you prefer and why? Paid ads, yes, Rajiv. Of course, we have to go about that because the demand is very high. The demand is 100,000 users in 24 weeks, so we have to go to the inorganic approach. Aggressive ad promotion on all mobile users, yes. LinkedIn, no, Siddhartha, it won't help us in the starting stage. Facebook, yes. FB, Twitter, Instagram. Instagram will help, FB will help, Twitter will also help. Add on food sites, yes. Now that is the point. That is, you're going out of the box. Yes, Rajiv. Anybody who can give a similar answer to what Rajiv is saying. Related to food, what is food site? Can you just precisely say to me that where do you want to advertise it? Or to reach remarketing, can you explain what is remarketing? What do you mean by remarketing? But that's a new word. All right, I won't take much of the time. Rajiv, when you say ads on food sites, yes, but there are few ad food sites which won't allow you to add on that because you are direct competition. No, Zomato won't allow you because you're giving a rating. People who come on food site, pull them. But how? See, you can also use, like for example, you can use food bloggers as your tribe. So these are the tribes who spread word. Reviews, yes. So we're going to use all that. There is no precise answer in marketing at all. But it is better that we should do these kind of session and we get to increase our vision. So that was the idea that, alright, similar lines we had, again this question, but this is again on the marketing budget and not on the precise objective. Anyways, since we have only an hour left and for end 10-15 minutes, I want to keep it as an open question or session. So we are now going towards the creating ad in one of the tools, which is Facebook. For Quinto, Arushi, for Quinto, I suggest to start with going blogs, bloggers, penetrate them, approach them. This is what I start. See, there are two ways how do you understand marketing. And even in digital marketing, where it's a part of marketing. Every marketing actually boils down to the fact of word of mouth. There will be very few percentage, limited percentage, where you just like the ad and you just click on that and you purchase that. It creates an aura it creates a goodwill factor onto you, and you talk about it, you feel about it, talk about with your peer. So John, I'll answer that first. I'll answer Arushi. So word of mouth, you have to figure it out who are the best sources to give you word of mouth. So by reaching Facebook, yes, you are reaching to the direct target audience. Out of them, few of them are going to be the major tribe for you. So yes, Facebook makes sense in that perspective. Then bloggers, when it comes to food and rating especially, and things like that. So just figure it out what can be the points which can create a further trigger, and you just hit them and not the end consumer. So this is the approach in marketing which I prefer of going about. Perception is very different from reality, Arushi. Very different. It depends what is your end scale. If a blogger is able to give you 100 users, it's more than enough to have 20-30 bloggers on board, right? So you do not require many bloggers. I'm not saying that blogger is the only answer. I'm saying that it is one of these parts. Of course, you're gonna go, like for example, someone amongst you have said that we have to go with Facebook and paid advertisement. I said yes, we have to go that. But we cannot deny to the fact which is a long run and continuous running machine for us. And if it is not blog, it can be anything where these intellects in the food discuss things. So it can be, linking with chefs, linking with restaurants, but not on only on the advertisement on the restaurant, but somehow using the circuit. Throwing a goodwill party for them, and that way, though it is not very digital, it is quite little offline also. Yes, we can use. Yes, we can overlap that. We can use our blog on FB, Twitter, and everything else. Google AdSense, John, and AdWords make very, very sense well to get traffic on board, because Google has good penetration towards the online sphere. So the best tool to get traffic on board is Google. Use Google. Anyways, I'm coming to Facebook now. So you Google Ads, I didn't get you. John, can you repeat the question, please? Yes, I mean Google Ads. Anyway, let me come to Facebook now. Before I come to Facebook, I have to tell you one thing, that in digital marketing, you have to understand that creative, or for that matter, in any marketing, creative is as important as media. Now, what is creative? What is media in advertisement or marketing world? If you look onto this side, you'll see that there is Spider-Man disguised under a body of a person, right? Of a body of a man. The same way, for whatever ad promotion you see, either in online or offline, or print, TV, or onto the digital market marketing. Where you see is the media. Like for example, Facebook ad is a media. It will have certain size, it will have certain dimensions. But there is creative, the ad part of it, what you consume, the content part of it, the Spider-Man in the body of an actor, of a person. So this is the creative. So creative is as important as media. I'm sure that your dedication right now must have been greatly towards the media part of it, of what to use, how to use, where to use. But you have to give a great dedication and intellect towards how your creative is going to look like. If it's a youth brand, which colors are attractive? If it's a brand for women, which font size or colors will make sense? How big the ad should be? What, how much the copy should be the part of it? Yes, Facebook is media basically, and creative is the ad which you make and promote it on the Facebook. I'm answering to John, but again, I'm coming back to the discussion I was doing. So that is creative. So give yourself a great weightage of learning creative part of it also. If you want, you can request for a session on creative. I'll take a session on creative next. But that will be purely based on your request. Anyways, so this is the creatives of Womania. You can just look into it. Certain creatives, like you see here, this is the packaging. Certain creatives portray the category. Certain creatives just harp on the precise point of the price. Certain creatives makes one apparel out of the list of apparels we have and try to make it a hero and go through with this. So creative also have greater. Yes, John, you want to ask something? You were asking something, you're saying please. Anyways, John, can you just quickly ask the question you want to ask? And then I'll go towards Facebook. All right, I'm going to the Facebook. Meanwhile, John, you can ask the question. All right. See, if you go to the ad manager in Facebook, this is how the panel is going to look like. These are the number of the ads. You may start with first ad and this ad will come in the campaign. You can design a campaign. It will have different objectives to start with. We'll create one ad, try to learn how it goes. So first of all, you have to answer the question, why I want to do the Facebook ad, or is the Facebook campaign is a part of the whole digital marketing campaign which I want to do. If the answer is yes, you come to Facebook to promote it. The overall digital marketing objective can be different from Facebook marketing objective. Like for example, the overall marketing objective is 100,000 users in 24 weeks. For Quinto. Now that is the overall marketing objective. But since a Quinto is a very new, gray account is still available. John, I didn't get you, what does everyone ask? John, let's keep your question towards the end of the session, because let me concentrate on Facebook right now, so everybody gets into the Facebook and then we'll try to answer your query, right? Coming back to the Facebook, for example, Quinto is a new app. Now, for them, you are strategized for Facebook, I'm going to use for awareness purpose, let's say. I'm just taking a hypothetical example. So let's say you have decided that I'm going to use for maximum awareness and not for the ultimate conversion of the user. So for Facebook, the campaign objective can be different, whereas your ultimate campaign objective will remain whatever it is. For example, getting the final conversion to 100,000 users. So in the initial basis, let's say you have decided Facebook to be the main driver of the campaign, and in that for first 4 weeks you want, let's say, 10,000 page likes, at least on Quinto's page. This is your objective. So you believe that if we have 10,000 users on that, out of which there's going to be 20-30% of the try section over it. So we'll get a good traction and we'll start taking a lead from 5th week onwards. If this is your way, you can just, like for example, you can just go over there, click on create ad. And these are the objectives which come in front of you. Facebook started with 4 or 5 objectives. It moved towards 6, then 8, and now it is it has 10 objectives listed. So you want to boost your post. Sometimes what happens is generally marketers does this the phenomena that if they have kept rupees, let's say 10,000 for a day, what they do is they will dedicate 60% in boosting whatever their primary objective is. If their primary objective on a given date is to boost the page, they'll dedicate 6,000 towards that. They'll also try to bring very new post every day for new events, new happenings, new designs coming on the onto their sites or whatever. So they want to create a just pass on the message and not the overall page. So for that they boost page also, 20% or 30% they're going to dedicate towards boosting page. Then after doing a decent activity, they realize that my peer group now knows everything about it. So now I should go with website online store conversions or ultimate conversions. So they choose like sending people to website, or they can choose increase, like for example, there's increased conversation on your website. So that way they do. So for example, you have decided to go, let's say, for promote your page. And now when you have gone towards promoting your page, this is the ultimate objective. So the Facebook ad is gonna, wherever the Facebook ad is gonna be shown, out of the image and text, it will show the page like button so that people are prompted to click page like. And this is the name of the headline basically. So it is by default coming as Romania, so we'll go with that. And then there is next stage. Anybody finding it, whatever the question have in between, can just prompt a question in between, can stop me with putting a question in between. Next, so first you have chosen the objective, next you are choosing the target audience. So it gives you a liberty of not only throwing it at random, it also gives you an advantage of choosing a specific target. Like for example, Womania, if I take Womania.com as an example, it is targeted towards women between 14-15 and aspiration women 14-15 to somewhere around 40-45 at the max. So in the campaign, if you want that, we are going to do the age group of, let's say, 14 to 40. So it will be like 14 to 40. Locations, yes, you can choose the location also. Like for example, it's all over India has been chosen. So you can include, like for example, you can add New Delhi. Should come as New Delhi. And you wanna add on only on major metros, for example. So you'll do Mumbai, New Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai. Sorry. Chennai. And let's say a few like Bangalore. Bangalore is not taking. Let's say Chandigarh, Pune. These are hypothetical numbers, you can take anything, right? So it also gives you a thing that you are very specific. Or you are on a broader perspective, or you are on a in between. So you have chosen the locations. So users from this area will only be chosen. You can also choose the gender. I'm sorry, I'm just putting a hold in between John and asked the question, how do we fix pixel for conversion ratio? This can be done by using designing software. Whenever you create a creative or you create a ad, a still ad, from a JPEG, you do it using designing softwares like Corel Draw. So in there you have a power of fixing pixels. So as a in a pane, you can fix the size of the pixel, and then you can fit your creative amongst that boundary. This is how designing happens. So it is a part of creative actually, not the media lecture. So this is, I guess you must have understood it, but in detail we can only discuss once we are discussing creative. Alright, so now moving again to this, you have chosen women, you can choose men. You can also choose interest. For example, for us it makes sense, for women.com it makes sense that people who are interested, people as in the age group of 14 to 40 women who are interested in shopping, we're targeting that. We may find it okay. It makes sense that they should also be, if they're interested in food, probably they'll also be interested in, shopping. So if this is what we think, we can also select food habits. So you can go to the hobbies and activities and the list will come, and you can choose whatever depending upon the brand you are focusing. No, they don't give us pixel. I'm answering John in between. They don't give us pixel. Pixel is basically the size. It is like an inch or centimeter. Whatever you see on the screen comes out of a size of pixel. So nobody gives you pixel. They only give you the dimensions that the ad is should be of this and this size. Should be of this and this pixel. So nobody gives you pixel. You make in certain unit which is pixel, right? Okay. So this is how you can select the interest. You can also select the behavior, like are they engaged in digital activities or they are seasonal travelers. So based on behavior, so what you're doing is you're basically going specific to towards your target, and it is a very very good tool to use because it's avoiding wastage, right? It is avoiding a great wastage. And then you may include people who have already liked your page, or you may exclude the people who have liked your page. Mostly the strategy in the initial phase is to exclude the people who have already liked the page, because it is, there is no point in wasting money on them who already liked, because our objective is page like. So once your objective is page like, you try to reach to the every other person at the next round, rather than repeating the ad to the same people again and again. And then you come on to the budget part. All right, Arvishi has asked a question. I'm stopping in between to answer that. As a digital marketer, how do we know creatives? Do we need to know creative? Yes, of course. As an any marketer, Arvishi, you need to know creative, because once you get into the any company, they don't want to keep you always in the job of execution. You may start with at a level where you are doing mostly managing the ads like in this panel, but you have to gradually grow. I'm not saying that you will make the creatives. Creatives will be made by the creative agency or the graphic designer in amongst your team. You are one of the team who is coordinating it and choosing it. But you should have the power of choosing and denying. You should have the power of approving it. And if you don't know a bit about creatives, how creatives are made, what is copy, how a copy can be made, who are good graphic designer, what is the turnaround time of making a creative, which colors will make sense for your TG. Then if you don't know that, you will be limited always. There are different courses for creatives, and it is basically out of wisdom and learning. It cannot be, I don't think so, it can be taught specifically, but anything can be learned. So you should have a spirit of learning it, trying to explore it. Just try to read it and explore it. Like, for example, you read newspaper and you get to know about various facts and it increases your understanding and wisdom the same way it is about creative. Just try to, like, for example, make an assignment, right? Today we are sitting on 1st of November. Till the end of November, I'll see every ad and try to figure out what is, why they have chosen this color, what is, why they have chosen this size, why they have chosen this model, why an celebrity has been introduced in this ad, are they using it to the best potential, what they should have done, what they should not have done. Try to be critical of every ad and you'll quickly learn a habit of working on creatives, right? I'll give you a small example. This is for everybody else to follow. From tomorrow onwards, when you'll be on board, try to observe the outdoor ads. In outdoor ads, you'll see that there's 40 to 50% of the ads are those where there is so much text that you are unable to read it. Because once you're traveling on the road, you'll hardly get to have 4 or 5 seconds from your car or vehicle to see the ad. But then the big fonts work. But you will see that government ads or the ads which are not being, have been a great output, will have smaller fonts and not able to read it. The same you can do with the digital ads. Try to observe every digital ads and you'll figure it out that there are loopholes in the creative part of the digital ad also. Sometimes you do not find a click button, or sometimes the font is overlapping with the background color and you're not able to read it, the message properly, and things like that. So, all right, so I'm now moving on. Then it gives you a liberty to select the budget. You can select the budget of the whole campaign as a lifetime. Like, for example, you can go to the lifetime and, for example, it automatically is coming as 25,000 and they're giving 1 month default. So you can select, like, for example, you can start with today and it is ending on 1st of December, but you want, I want Christmas to be over and then the campaign will end. So you can change the campaign schedule accordingly. This is the whole campaign budget. You see that you have a budget, for example, you have parked a budget of 1 lakh for it, so you can do 1 lakh over it, things like that. Optimized for is, like, for example, you have chosen the objective for pay like, so it is coming as optimized for pay like. So there is one point which I want to make here. If you have chosen the objective as page like, so whatever amount is going to be deducted will be deducted on if somebody does a page like. But it is not always the case. If the page like is not happening while Facebook is promoting your ad, they are going to automatically deduct either the same amount or relatively lesser. Even when there are great number of impressions, especially in the multiple of thousands. So, for example, if there are 1,000 impressions being made of this page like ad, but none of person has clicked that, they're gonna charge the same amount or lesser amount according to their algorithm, which works real time. So it is not that it will only be deducted only and only if somebody does a page like. No. If they are doing an exercise for you and throwing it to number of people, they are gonna charge you somehow, right? So you have kept a day budget or a lifetime budget. For example, you have kept a day budget of 500 rupees and you have kept it as an automatic bidding. So what happens is, once you create it and throw it for public to see, then your daily budget has been parked as 500. So for example, in the initial phases, the algorithm is expecting a bid of, let's say, 11 rupees 20 paisa. So if somebody clicks that, 11 rupees 20 paisa will be gone. The other person clicks and that time the bid is 9 rupees and 9 rupees will become the same. So it will never increase more than 500 for a day. So it basically, there's a very complex algorithm. The behavior scientist and the analyst work in Facebook or Google, and it works accordingly. So they work for the best optimization. So you're going to get the best results once you keep it on an auto grid. All right. Then the last step, which is creating an ad. Now here the creative part comes into the picture. So you can create an ad, you can make a video ad, you can also make a image oriented ad. So here you can select the image, you can just go over there, you can browse from your library of the creative which you have made, and you can choose the ad. Like for example, you can browse and it open up the folder where you have kept the ads, and you can just browse and go over there. For example, I want this ad to be done. Well, click okay, and this will come. All right. Now there is one thing which you need to understand. For different objectives, the ad style, the creative part differs. So Facebook gives you a specification depending upon which type of objective you have chosen. This is the major thing. Like for example, if your objective is click on the website, they give you a liberty of putting an ad of the size of 1200 by 628 pixels and a ratio of 1.9:1. This is a creative language, but does everybody understand what is image ratio? If none of you does that, just say no so that I can answer that. Excuse me, I'm not getting you your voice. Okay, Rajiv, I'm answering. You're not getting my voice. Jacob, are you able to listen to my voice now? Am I audible to you? Okay, meanwhile, I'm answering the image ratio. For example, if this is the image, my voice is breaking. Is it proper now? Is it proper now?
No.
All right, now it's all fine. Fine. See, if this is the image, you can see over here on the bar that it starts with 10 and somewhere around 11, goes up to 11. So this in pixels, it can be certain percentage, certain pixels. So it is 10, 11 to 11 over here, and on the width, it is 8 to 8. So it is 8 to 6 point something. So it is basically of a ratio of 1:1, width into height. So it is basically, like for example, if an image is of 1200 by 600, I'm taking a hypothetical example in pixels. So its ratio will be width into height 2:1, right? 600 into 2 is 12. So it is on a size of 2:1, right? This is how a creative is made out of a certain ratio. So this is the image ratio. Why it is important? Because when a creative is made on a laptop or on a computer, it is generally made on a size, not the actual size. Like for example, for a digital thing, you want a bigger, high pixelate creative. So they are not going to make it over that and render it, because that way it will become too heavy. So what they do is, if the pixel requirement is 5000 to 5000, they will do they'll make an creative in 1:1 and keep it at the highest resolution. It depends upon the host size. Arushi, you have asked me that how do we decide this ratio. Every image which you see, everything which you see either in the normal world or in a computer or any ad in newspaper, everything is of a particular size. So your wall is of a particular size. You will decide what kind of size you want based on what is your, you know, requirement. So if in Facebook you want to put an ad, they'll give you the size. Jacob has said at what time I do close. I have a message. Jacob, it'll close at 10:30. So we'll end the session. I'll log in again, and if you want any queries, I'll respond to you after 10:30, right? Or you're asking me, what are you asking me, sir? At what time it will close? All right. Anyways, this is the this is about the ratio, right? Now how do we know what size is perfect for which place? 100% size is perfect for that place, right? You have to use your idea of what you want to portray. Like, for example, I tell you, for this slide, the size of the slide was 12:12. You can look onto the platform, white platform of the slide. It is 12:12. Now I decide that the optimum size for this image to convey whatever I want to say will be of whatever size I've kept as an image, because I want to write the text also, you know, beneath that. So if I would have used the full image onto the full slide platform, I would not have got the space to write the text. So this is basically of whatever platform you're using. Wherever you are creating an ad on that platform, then you use your idea to what can be the best size. For certain things, like for example Facebook, you're gonna get the dimension. For example, for page like, this is the size which they're recommending. Like I can show you here, like look on over here on the right hand side, recommended image specification. It is saying that recommended image size is 1200 by 444. You can upload an image, it will get approved of 1200 by 440 also, but it will not be of the best size which Flipkart has kept for this kind of objective, because they work accordingly. So the image ratio is coming as 2.67:1. So if you divide 1200 by 444, you're gonna get 2.67. Then there is another part which Flipkart is very, very rigid of. It is rigid of that for the image, the copy which you're going to use, copy is the text which you write over the image, that can only be the 20% of the whole size of the image. So if you divide the whole image into grids and equal size grids, it cannot occupy more than 20% of the total grids which are made. So if there are, let's say, if this particular image is been divided from length to breadth amongst the equal size grid and it comes out to be 20 grids, then at the max you can use the text only in two grids. So it is an example I'm saying. Why does they do that? Say do that to maintain the hygienic value of Facebook. They want ads to be shown in a particular manner. They don't want it to be misused. So they don't want the ads which are specific. They have dedicated this space for the image part, because you can write the description over that, you can write the heading Romania, you can write beneath that. So in the context, they know that if you're going to make fully, every ad will be of different cosmetic value, so they don't want it to be disturbed. Like for example, of whatever stall or a final shop you want in a mall is the ultimate prerogative of mall to decide that. Can you keep those products and can you keep it like that? So you have to get that approvals, because the customer is not coming to only shop in your shop in the mall. It is coming to experience the mall experience. So they have the responsibility of making a particular hygiene and positioning value in the mind of the consumer. Like for example, when you go to a Cello City Walk, you have a particular positioning in your mind of how you perceive Cello City Walk, or a DLF mall, or any other, or a Garuda mall in Bangalore, for that example. So even in Facebook, the purpose of creating an ad is not, when you visit Facebook as a user, you want to use Facebook experience. this comes as a bonus, ads comes as a bonus. They are not the main product. So they have to maintain the hygienic value of it. And that is the reason there are guidelines towards it. So that the guidelines, if you're gonna choose this objective, is that the image size is gonna be 1200 by 444 pixels in a ratio of 2.6 to 1, and the image shall not increase more than this. This is how in mobile it's gonna look like. The same ad, right? And the like button is coming, and the user can just click that and will automatically add it. All right, then you place order. Once you place order, your order gets into the review state. You can look over here, it's getting into the review state. It will take some time for Facebook management team. It also works an automatic algorithm behind in the Facebook office, and it gets approved from their side. Once it gets approved, it will automatically start working on the boundaries of budgets which you have kept. Right? So anybody have any question related to Facebook right now? First, we'll take questions related to the Facebook creation ad which we have done. That concept. All right. We still have nice. It is clear to all. One thing I want to say, just practice it. Take out 100 rupees, try to boost your personal post or whatever you're doing. Just use this panel. Use this panel for next 7-8 days, 10 days continuously. Spend 50 rupees, 100 rupees, whatever little money you want to do in that. It gets you hands on. Or you can create a virtual product also. You can create a simple logo from, there are various sites where you can create a logo. So just create a simple product, anything. Create a blog, free blogging site, try to promote it through Facebook page, create a Facebook, do something like that. It not only enhances your entrepreneurial skill, it also enhances your creativity in using Facebook promotions. Once you are done with that, you can also try Google AdWords and AdSense. They also work on the same platform. Google AdWords work on the same platform. I mean, the structure is more or less the same. Here you have blue color, they'll have red color. Here you, there also in the first page, you have to choose the objectives. The list of the objectives can be different because there are search engine and it's a social media site. But at the end of the day, few of the objectives are going to be common. There will be few objectives will be different. But the panel of how to use it will be very, very similar. It will be 80-90% similar. So if you are in hands-on with Facebook, you will be hands-on with Google AdWords. And social media segment, and this is in a similar way can be done, right? All right, now this is about Facebook creating ad. I'm going to continue. Now we'll, all right, there are two thoughts which I want to share before we end up or take last questions. The first thing is, out of industry, on behalf of industry as well as on the general point, I'm saying that you should be like a financier and not an accountant. So this should be your basic premise. So for digital marketer, you should not only be an executioner. So out of the whole course, execution at the end of the day, when you start working as a digital marketer, will only be limited to 20-30% of your work. The rest, it goes towards the planning of it, like what to do, how to achieve the objectives, try and test it. If you're not going to achieve, let's say for example, you have thought that you're going to get 10,000 Facebook users of a specific target in such and such monies, and you're not able to achieve that, then you have to try something else and use it. So try to be a finance manager, not an accountant. This is what I mean, right? So this goes, right? And I'm sure if you're going to use that, it will create an impact and bulb jalega boss. So this is what I want to say out of this session. Now we have 15-20 minutes left. Let's take the questions, and the questions can go from any dimension. Can go from the ad perspective, from the career perspective, and but related to marketing and digital marketing, and go from e-commerce. Just throw any questions which you want to throw. I try to answer that. There was one question I have asked somebody that I'll answer at the end. I'm sorry, I just forgot what was the question and who asked it. So you can just repeat your question. Yes, there is no noise now. Oh yes, Santosh, you asked me that on where to apply for the post. There are various things. If you want to start with a startup, then there is one site, angel.co/jobs, angel.co/jobs. Register over there and you will see India's very, very new creative startups coming over there. So they offer their startup jobs, and if you select the category digital marketer, I'm sure you're gonna see that every new day there are digital marketing jobs requiring over there. So this will be under various heads like digital marketer, digital executive, chief digital executor, growth hacker, in these heads. No, I disagree somehow. They may ask for the experience, but you have the certificate to compensate this experience. I can speak about the young companies especially. I want to include myself into it as a young entrepreneur, a young company. It depends on the solution you can give to the company, especially with a company who haven't touched more than 100 crore mark. They basically works as a departmental structure of a startup where there are only, you know, one head for this, one head for this, one team for this, one team for this. Not a big hierarchical structure like in an established company. For them, working in various domains is what makes sense. Achieving the objective, have a good spirit towards work is main highlight, not the experience. And so, yes, out of an experience thing, you are gonna get into. I mean, if I have an experience of, let's say, 5 years or 10 years, I'm taking a hypothetical example. If somebody has an experience under its sleeve for 5 years or 10 years and you are its competition, it's going to have its edge. But you can just convince them to get an entry as a junior level to what their expectation. But again, you can just get the entry. Of course, I'm going to get the edge if I have experience in this sleeve and I'm going to have the higher designation also. But this is not like that. And even in established companies, people are increasing their budgets. This is what I'm saying. And when they increase their budget, they need somebody to handle the overall perspective. And they also need somebody to work in assistance to that. So you, as a fresher, may be an assistant in the starting, but you can overlead them if you have brains, right? So don't be discouraged about that. Oh, Santosh, I'm answering. Wait. As I told you in the beginning, I want to switch to digital marketing. Can you just complete? Yes, you want to switch to digital marketing. So what is the problem? You have this course, you know a little bit about digital marketing now. Just keep on applying to the digital requirements. Use Angel if in case you are interested in startups or recently funded companies. Go to this angel.co, I'm writing it down, angel.co/jobs. Register yourself and you'll see that you have crazy new startups coming over there. You can also register on various other portals and look for. All right, Santosh, are you satisfied? Do you know any company that you're looking for. There are many companies, you just check on the net, there are many companies. I mean, every startup needs a digital marketer, especially if it's in an online space. Many companies in hyper, Jacob, I'll answer you first. I'm answering Arushi's question because I wasn't that close. Santosh and Arushi, the question got linked. There are hyper local companies which provide hyper local logistics like Jugnu.com, Passwords.com, and Passwords.com, and companies like that. So, there you can go. They always need digital marketers. There are various food apps, they need digital marketers. There is WeGulp, there are various. I mean, just search it down for apps in various segments. Look out for the apps, and whatever new app you're going to see, they will be requiring digital marketers. In startups, there are many companies. Yes, Santosh, you are from traditional marketing and you want to go with. I'm answering Santosh now because he has been asking this question from long. Santosh, if I'm able to understand your question, you're saying that you're from a traditional background and now you want to make a switch to digital marketing. How you're going to do that, or you probably are finding some difficulties in doing that? It won't be difficult. It needs your courage. There is no fixed formula that you're going to do accordingly. But the step which you have taken up and of taking this course in itself is a very good step, and it is what is required now. After, in the end of this course, you will be in a position to know, to talk, to implement digital marketing. Do and hand practice case studies, make a virtual product, do a case study, take a note of it, and go to any company wherever there is digital marketing interviews going on. And in the interview, doesn't matter, Santosh, if you have 5 year experience. Doesn't matter. I'll tell you, the people like me or people from my earlier generation, when they have studied their marketing, digital marketing was not into the domain, was not existence in India. When I've done my marketing masters, digital marketing was not in sphere. But that doesn't mean that I don't know marketing or I'm not practicing marketing. I'm practicing marketing for 2-3 companies now. And I'm working on as a consultant in 6-7 companies. So, and I've started when I was having experience of 6-7 years. So it doesn't matter, you can start it, right? Yeah, this is something which Santosh has said that, Santosh, you are saying that they will. Required package can be a problem. Yes, they can be. So you can try to approach those companies where the role is for both, where the role is for to handle complete marketing with digital marketing as a part of it. So try to approach those companies, and there you can get a good breakthrough. And there are, I mean, every company now needs that, except startups. Any company which is relatively 1 year or two year old, and specifically if selling an online product, alright, Santosh, now moving to Jacob's question. Jacob, I'm coming to you. I'm sorry, but since there are so many questions thrown straight away, I missed your question. Sir, after leaving of this thing, how many ways I can earn money? Achha, so learning this, how many ways you can earn money? First and the foremost way of you can learn, you can earn money is by starting your own enterprise of whatever idea you or your friend have. So you'll get a good experience of how to promote it. This is the best thing required for an enterprise. You can just start on working that idea, try to bring some technical guy into it. If in case it's an online based product, try to make an app or website out of it and set the operations. Just start doing that now. That is one. You can be a digital marketer for sure, maybe at an entrance level. Third, you can be a consultant. Fourth, you can join any agency who does online marketing for various companies. So do you think that they have full-fledged teams for example, Maruti or Samsung or take any company, Panasonic, do you believe that they have, or any apparel brand, would you believe that they have the full marketing team under them? No. These marketing managers in these companies not do the execution part. They only approve and disapprove. There are various agencies right now. In Delhi, there must be somewhere around 300, 400 agencies who are only working online advertisement for various clients, small or big. So you can join them, be a consultant, take outsource projects from them. You can take anything. Like for example, you'll learn how to do Facebook. Now you can go to the agencies and say that whatever projects you are getting, I'll do a part-time man hours for you, and I'll handle the Facebook promotion for the project you have, and give me money so you can learn as a freelancer as well. Yes, Santosh, you can learn as a you can work as a freelancer. Good, if Jacob, if you have that idea and it's potential enough. As Santosh, I don't want to use this platform to advertise for others. So you can just search it down. There are various, every company now requires digital, and for freelancing you can approach any company who is doing digital marketing service or making websites or making apps. So they always have the digital marketing segment. I'll name a couple. Pulp Strategy is one. You can approach them. Any digital marketing company will have that kind of freelancing project line with them. So you can do with them. Try to approach Pulp Marketing. That's a good company actually. But I should not name more than one. This is what I mean. All right, Jacob. It's good if you have a good idea. I wish you all the best. Just work on it. Watch. So Vinay is asking something from Facebook promotion. Can we generate ideas? Yes. One idea I've anyways given you. You can only work in a niche and project yourself as the project guy who can handle Facebook promotions for anyone. So you can approach small companies to handle that. You can approach agencies to get the outsourced work. You can approach the big agencies to give them consultation and work from them. So if you know how to do Facebook promotion, these are the ideas you can work upon. I want to know specific data. SPSS data. SPSS is basically data research tool. Common. This is if in case you want a course over it, you have to approach the administration of Paathshala. I'm only taking guest lecture over here, so I can't respond you on that. So if in case they have certain kind of course on SPSS, surely they'll arrange something for you. Should we get inquiry? Yes. Make a Facebook page. Project yourself as a, like for example, people project themselves as a software developer, as an Android developer, as an Magento developer, as an PHP developer. You project yourself as a Facebook advertiser. And I'm sure there will be companies who will be interested in that. Try to use these SEO skills which you have done. Try to use the Facebook promotion to promote your Facebook page as a project manager for Facebook. And I'm sure you're going to land up somewhere good with good projects. You'll get inquiries. Anybody, I'm answering Vinay as of now. Anybody who thinks that for their idea, will they get or not get inquiry? I can make a philosophical entrepreneurial statement right now. We have enough people with various demands and aspirations across the board. Leave about world, only in India we have such a great population and a great segment in youth. Whatever idea you have, you will surely get certain bias. It's only you how you reach them. So that is why these courses are important. Can you send freelancer website links? Can you get some links you can buy ideas? You can search it down and do a homework from yourself, Jacob. If everybody have people as an end consumer who is ultimately investor is going to spend as a money on the buying ideas and the ultimate freelancer and everything, then nobody will be requiring a network or talking or during these sessions. It's not as easy as you think, Jacob, that everything is ready and it can be. Just you got the outline of how to approach it. Google is a great platform. Search it down. Connect to one company. Try to connect to other companies through that. Try to connect one people. Try to connect other people from that. So do an homework from yourself, Jacob. This is what I recommend. I'm sure I may not have missed any questions. Santosh, are you satisfied with the answer? All right. Try to go to the company, Santosh, where they offer both. And nowadays, a company which is 2-3 year old, which is in a growth trajectory, which has a revenue of 20-30 crores to 70-80 crores, there you will find your best purpose fulfilled, right? And there you will find both the things to handle online, and then a desired package as well. All right. Any more questions? And so that we are about to reach 10:30 will end up. Right. All the best, Santosh. All the best, Jacob, Vinay, Kamal, and everybody else. Any more question? Arushi, thanks a lot for being here. And if I'm missed any name, thanks for joining in for this session. Thanks. All right. Thanks, Santosh, for the feedback. In fact, I want every one of you to just share in one line in whatever way they want to share the feedback. That will help me in shaping the further sessions as well. So, just share the feedback of the session, please. Thanks, Santosh. It was a different session. I hope you have enjoyed it. I hope you have learned it, and it will make sense for you. All right, Rishi, thanks. That was the idea, to keep informative as informative. I think I'm missing Kamal's question over here. SPSS value leveling in Excel. Kamal, SPSS tool is something which we are not discussing it right now. Why don't you just approach Nick or the other administrator of Paathshala and try to get engaged with them. I'm sorry, I'm so very sorry, Kamal. I won't be able to help you out in SPSS today. They can probably help you out in SPSS. Where can I get a video because I missed? Again, you have to contact Nick for that, Jacob. Right now, I don't think I'm in an authority to share the video. You can approach him if in case whatever, and he may share it with you. So you can approach him and he'll share it with you. Santosh is saying it was a different session. I like the planning part. Thank you. Vinay is saying we have added SEO new service in my company profile. Very good. So you can contribute over. You are contributing, Vinay, in SEO right now into your company? Oh, nice. You can contribute in Facebook if in case that. I'm sorry, Vinay, I just missed. You probably would have told me in what company you are working. You just repeat it again. I'm so very sorry. I just forgot. Thanks, Jacob. I may have missed because the session is going on continuously. I was speaking and there are continuous questions coming. I probably may have missed a question or two. So if in case I missed any question, you can repeat the question right now. And it's already 10:30, so I'm answering few questions. So anybody who want to leave can leave in case they're full with the session. So I'll answer every question and then I'll leave. Oh, Vinay, nice. Which company you have? And what do you do? I'm in another company. right choice edition. And you are into? Why? Very good. And if you are open in digital marketing, I'm not very sure if you are into conventional marketing or digital or both. And if you are into digital, then you can give a good number of projects to the fellow mates over here. And you all can work hand in glove. And very good. If you are into website development, you whenever you are meeting your clients for website designing and development, I'm sure you must have getting queries, or you can push a digital marketing contract with them, because for any new website development or designing, they ultimately gonna need you guys to promote that, right? So you can do that. So Vinay has a great potential to right, you can do accordingly. Nice, very very nice. If you get 100 clients, congrats for that. I wish to have more zeros behind this 100 figure. Alright, so shall we end this session, or we have any other question left? Acha, there is one thing. If none of you have logged out, I want to share just one thing. I forgot to share it, of how if not done properly, a marketing can be used to hamper the brand image. Santosh, I'm not very sure if I'm allowed to share the contact right now. Please contact the administrator for it. If they permit, I will, or you can ask my details from them. So this is what I want to show everybody. Just a little patience with me for a minute more, and I'll give a very interesting point over here. Just hold on. Yeah. Now look into this ad, an email promotion, mass email promotion by Renault Kwid. Kwid is a new brand which Renault has launched in competition to Alto. It is ranging from X showroom from 2.6 to around 3.5. So on road, a good model comes around 3.5 to 4 lakh rupees. And recently, Baleno was also launched, which starts with 5.5 on road in Delhi. So it starts with X showroom, and it's a master stroke, which I say from Maruti, because it's not only gonna give competition to i20, then its own stable product Swift. It's Baleno is so very good in all the aspects, especially in exterior beauty, that it's gonna give competition to products even in higher range of 8 to 10 lakhs, including cross SUVs like EcoSport, Duster, etc. But there is one thing which is quite interesting over it. This mail is saying that it is getting me from Renault, but it is actually from cardeco.com, and then showing this ad, right? You can see that. You click anywhere in this ad, it's a Kwid ad, right? There's a TVC of a Kwid. But you just click anywhere on this ad and look onto the page, it opens. It opens Baleno. It doesn't open Kwid anywhere. It opens Baleno. So it's an outsourced marketing effort. A company is working hand in glove, Cardeco and Kwid and Baleno separately. But Cardeco is working separately with Renault, working separately for Maruti Baleno to push their product. But see what mistake they have done. But I don't think so it's a mistake, it's a deliberate effort. They must have been charging heavily from Baleno searches, or if somebody click on go to road price from Baleno, this is how they must be charging from from Maruti, and they're using Kwid as a tool, as Renault as a tool. So Renault is paying on behalf of Baleno. So this is the misuse of a powerful tool called internet marketing or digital marketing. So you show something, you make ultimately consumer land into something else. So I don't know which one is in fault. Is it the outsourced company of Car Deco, or it is Car Deco, or it is the bribing effort of Maruti? But at the end of the day, people like me, who is a tribe of marketing, can notice that, can write somewhere, can portray somewhere and try to bring a bad name or try to bring a correct name, if I can say, to the wrongdoers. But at the end of the day, Quid is paying, or Renault is paying for something which Maruti is enjoying. So even that is very common in internet marketing, right? So that's it. That is something which I want to share with you guys. All right. So how did you find this very particular example? I mean, this Renault and Maruti link or a thing. How do you find it? Do you find it interesting, or do you find it that, or you know about this earlier that this kind of thing happens? Of course, it's not right, Santosh. That is why I am trying to spread it as much as possible. Yes, they are not making, Santosh, they are not only making mistake on the or bluffing customer, they are also doing on both the supplying and the buying side. So that is not expected, but this is what I said when I said how aggregators do. They're in a pressure, a continuous pressure of bringing the user base, the registered user base, the searches, whatever their currency is there, onto the higher decimal. The Flipkart currency is GMV, but Quikr or Car Deco, sites like these are informative that the currency is as many searches as, you know, number of searches, number of user base and all that. So whatever currency these products have, they, since they are aggregators, they are not selling the hard product as such. They try to increase this as much as possible and comes up with that kind of report to the investor to get more money, to get more business, to get more companies on board, on brands on board. Anyways, we can go on like this for discussion, but since we have ended this session and it's I think we should end this session now. Anybody have, I'm opening the floor for the last time so that we just not done well then end the session. All right. Jacob, shall we end this? Because I guess you want to ask some questions. So if in case not, then we'll ask everybody to switch off and then you can. Alrighty, so let's end this session. Thanks everyone. Thanks for being part. Alright, thank you.